بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم يسألونك عن الأنفال قل الأنفال لله والرسول فاتقوا الله وأصلحوا ذات بينكم.
9 from Surah Al-Anfal, and inshallah we'll continue. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم ولو ترى إذ يتوفى الذين كفروا الملائكة يضربون وجوههم وأدبارهم وذوقوا عذاب الحريق ذلك بما قدمت أيديكم وأن الله ليس بظلام للعبيد كدأب آل فرعون والذين من قبلهم كفروا بآيات الله فأخذهم الله بذنوبهم إن الله قوي شديد العقاب. Beautiful آيات الله سبحانه وتعالى says, ولو الله عز وجل describing here how the angels taking the souls of the disbelievers. For the angels taking the souls of the believers and the souls of non-believers. Non-believers, here. So when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala taking the soul in the way, taking the souls of the believers, and the, Allah azza wa jalla said in the hadith in Sahih Muslim, the Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala send an angels, and the man is in the man or the woman, of course, the person in the process of death. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala send beautiful angels, and the angels waiting for the soul to leave the body. Now, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put the soul in Prophet Adam alayhi salam, he start from his head, from his brain, and the souls reach his eyes and his nose and his mouth, and Adam alayhi salam start to move the mouth and the stomach. Adam alayhi salam start to get hungry, and then Adam alayhi salam went to, he saw the trees of the Jannah and the fruits of the Jannah and the foods of the Jannah, he want to go and eat. Then he fell down until the soul reached all the way to the toes and the feet of Adam alayhi salam. So that, of course, start from the head all the way to the toes. Now is the opposite. The angels will take the soul frozen. So in this, the soul will leave the body of a human being from the toes all the way to the brain. So Allah, the angels of mercy will take the soul of a human being, and the angel of the believers, and the angel of punishment will take the soul of the disbelievers. And here the soul of the believers will be wrapped in very beautiful kafan from the Jannah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala send it, and the soul will go to the first heaven all the way to the Sidrat al-Muntaha, to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will bless the soul. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless the soul and send the soul back to the grave. Send the soul back to the grave. And of course, by the blessing of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then the grave will be part of the Jannah, part of the paradise. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make our graves part of the paradise. Ameen ya Rabbil Alameen. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in this ayah says, وَلَوْطَىٰ إِذْ يَتَوَفَّى الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا. Here Allah Azza wa Jalla describing the other part of the disbelievers, how they die, especially in the Battle of Badr. After Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala take the soul by the angels, they will be hit by the angels. Because what can happen here? Let me give you attention to this. The soul will be spread in the body, as the hadith of Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The soul will be spread over the body, running. The soul don't want to leave the body because the soul knows it's going to go for punishment. So the soul will be taken from the body, wal-iyadu billah, just like what? Like a wet cotton, as the Prophet ﷺ described it, wet cotton. And it will be a stick of a thorn, and taken from the wet cotton. Very snatched. Of course, the angel will be hit that disbeliever, wal-iyadu billah. The angels will be hitting the disbelievers. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَلَقَالَ الَّذِينَ يَتَوَفَّى الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا الْمَلَائِكَةِ يَضْرِبُونَ وُجُوهَهُمْ وَأَدْبَارَهُمْ. They will be hitting their faces and their backs. for the soul in order for the soul to leave the body, for the order in order for the soul to leave the body. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us from that. Ameen. وَسَوْ ذُوقُوا عَذَابَ الْحَرِيقِ. Here taste the punishment, وَالْعِيَادُ بِاللَّهِ. Taste the punishment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Hariq here, from harq, from fire. Hariq, the word of hariq is fire. وَالْعِيَادُ بِاللَّهِ. So those people will be in this fire. Those people will be in this fire. Then Allah, the angels telling those people in advance, taste the punishment of the fire. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us from that. Ameen ya Rabbil Alameen. Say, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, ذَلِكَ بِمَا قَدَّمَتْ أَيْدِيكُمْ وَأَنَّ اللَّهَ لَيْسَ بِظَلَّامٍ لِلْعَبِيدِ. Allahu Akbar. Say, that what you have done in your life. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give you the Quran, give you the Sunnah, send you prophets, give you all those signs. And then what happened after all those signs? وَالْعِيَادَ بِاللَّهِ. You deny. The person deny. All those signs, proves, all those proofs, all the prophets, all the ayat, all the signs, they deny those ayat. May Allah protect us from that. So Allah says, ذَلِكْ بِمَا قَدَّمَتْ أَيْدِيكْ. What you have done in your hands, what you are committed by your own hands. Say Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, وَأَنَّ اللَّهَ لَيْسَ بِظَلَّامٍ لَيْسَ بِظَلَّامٍ. Say Allah never be unjust or unfair for the believers. Always Allah, in fact, subhanallah, the hadith of the ayah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, if you commit a sin, if you commit, if the person commit a sin, what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give that person? Only one sin. Sin. But if you ask Allah for forgiveness, what's going to happen to this sin? This sin will be completely erased. This sin will be erased. And the opposite here. If you do hasana, good deeds, rewards, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala multiply it how many times? How many times Allah will multiply it? 10 times. Not only that, وَاللَّهُ يُضَاعِفُ لِمَنْ يَشَاءُ بِغَيْرِ حِسَابٍ. Allah multiplies for everyone more and more. And also when you're committing a sin and ask Allah for forgiveness, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala change it to good deeds, hasana. What else we need after this? So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, telling the ذَلِكَ بِمَا قَدَّمَتْ أَيْدِيكُمْ. That what we committed by your hands. وَأَنَّ اللَّهَ لَيْسَ بِظُلَّمَ. Allah will never be unjust or unfair for His servants. And now Allah Azza wa Jalla says, كَدَأْبِ آلِ فِرَعُونَ وَالَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِهِمْ. Say that what the people of Pharaoh, the Pharaoh of Allah Azza wa Jalla described those people, because this Pharaoh, the king of the Egypt, he always said, I am God. Send not a prophet, send two prophets, Musa and his brother Harun, to those people. Musa and Harun together to those people. For what? For those to believe. And still, because Allah Azza wa Jalla says, Fir'aun, ala, ala fi ard, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned that in Surah Taha. But he said, I am Rabbukum, I am your Lord. وَالْعِيَادُ بِاللَّهِ. May Allah protect us from that. Ameen, ya Rabbil Alameen. Say, كَدَابِ آلِ فِرْعَوْنَ. Not only, وَالَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِهِمْ. The people before Fir'aun and after Fir'aun. The people before and after, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, Allah punished them, what they committed by their own hands. They deny and disbelieve in their prophets. They disbelieve in their prophets and messengers. Then what happened to them? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will punish them. وَالْعِيَادُ بِاللَّهِ. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, مِنْ قَبْلِهِمْ. كَفَرُوا بِآيَاتِ اللَّهِ. They denied the ayat, the signs of Allah. They denied the prophets and the messengers. Alright? Say that's the people of Salih. That is Salih. Naqatullah. What is the name of Naqatullah? Say that Salih alayhi salam. He Allah said Naqa, that cow. I say, what is the name of the cow? Anybody can tell me what is the name of the cow of Salih alayhi salam? She camel, yes, that's it. Naqatullah, that's what we call it, Naqatullah. There is no name for it except Naqatullah, the she camel. And then what happened to the she camel? They deny, they kill it. And the people look, and Allah, those people, they having huge houses inside the mountains. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala destroyed those camels, those houses, wal'iyadu billah. So, كَتَالَ مِنْ ذَذِيُّ كَفَرُ بِآيَاتِ اللَّهِ فَأَخَذَهُمُ اللَّهِ بِذِنُوبِهِمْ. Listen to this ayah. This word, فَأَخَذَهُمْ. Allah punished them by their sin. What they committed by their own sins, وَالْعِيَادُ بِاللَّهِ. The people of Lut, May Allah protect us about from those people. Ameen. فَاللَّهُ قَالَ إِنَّ اللَّهَ قَوِيٌّ شَدِيدُ الْعِقَابِ. Allah the most powerful, stronger Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So, again, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, إِنَّ اللَّهَ قَوِيٌّ. قَوِي, the most powerful. This word, whoever think that he is stronger, Allah is more stronger. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the stronger. No one is strong but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Whatever you become, as the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, any bird, you know the birds, Allah go up and up and up, after the birds go up with the highest place, the birds, the eagle is go the highest place. After that, the eagle, when he see a rat or a mice down there, the eagle will go down and go up and down until the eagle getting older and older and older. And then what happened after that? What happened? It's gonna go die. So whoever go up and up and up, one day, soon and or later, will come down. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah is the qawi. Allah never go down. It's always Allah qawi. Shadid al-iqab, Allah take the revenge from those people. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us from that. This ayah is coming up. It's repeated also in Surah Ra'd. Ayah number 11, if I'm not mistaken. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Inna Allah, this ayah here first in number 53. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Dalika bi'anna Allah lam yakum ghayran ni'matan an'amaha ala qawmin hatta yughayyiru ma bi'anfusihim wa anna Allah sami'un alim. Allah azza wa jalla never change. Allah not going to change any favor, any bounties that Allah Azza wa Jalla had given to the people. And did the people, they change themselves first. Themselves, Allah Azza wa Jalla gave this ayah twice in the Quran. In this, in Surah Al-Anfal, ayah number 53, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala repeated again also in ayah number 11 in Surah Al-Ra'd. In ayah number 11 in Surah Al-Ra'd, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, ayah says in Surah Al-Ra'd, Inna Allah la yughayyiru ma biqawmin hatta yughayyiru ma bi'anfusihim. Allah knows not going to change any nation, any people, until the people themselves, they will change themselves first. That is the ni'mah. You know the people of Fir'aun? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave those people everything. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave those people everything. They give power, mercy, bounties, money, wealth. Everybody in that time, in that area is rich. No poor, no poverty. But subhanAllah, still they disbelieve in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So, this ayah repeated twice, the people, when they change themselves, then they can change the others. You cannot change the others without changing yourself. You have to start with your own self to change the others. Just like husband and wife, as I mentioned yesterday in the lecture, or the day before yesterday, for the woman to change her husband, the woman she have to change first. Or the opposite. The man, he want to change his wife to be good, or the husband to be good, the man or the woman, they have to change themselves. They have to show this role model first in order for the other person to be changed. Then you're going to change the society around you. But if you want to change all this society around you, you cannot change yourself. You have to change yourself. The change comes from the person first. Then you can change the other. You can change the other. Alright, so Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, ذَلِكَ بِأَنَّ اللَّهَ لَمْ يَكُمْ غَيْرًا نِعْمَةً أَنْعَمَهَا عَلَىٰ قَوْمٍ. Allah give favors and bounties to any nations as a test to be grateful, thankful, or وَلْعِيَدُ بِهَا the opposite way. See, حَتَّى يُغَيِّرُ مَا. Till they change themselves, deny this ni'mah, they say this is not from Allah, from a king, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will take this ni'mah from the people. May Allah protect us from that. Ameen ya Rabbil Alameen. وأن الله سميع عليم. سميع, الله عز وجل hear everything. Whoever whisper to yourself, even whispering to yourself, talking to yourself, Allah so know exactly what you are talking to yourself, what you are saying to yourself. Subhanallah. So عليم knows what the people wants to. Allah knows what the people wants, but Allah testing the people with the ni'mah. with the bounty, testing the people. With the power.